Hey guys, welcome back to Gunshots. As you are aware, last week I had a first look at the Beretta 694, and now I've had a week to shoot it. I've had a huge response to the video. I've had a lot of questions, and I think I'm going to answer them for you today and hopefully give you some definitive answers. In short, I really like this gun. I'll do the techie bits first. As you're aware, the gun comes cased in the rather nice attractive silver case with the blue velvet lining. We get Optima HP chokes, the nice extended colour-coded ones. The gun is 18.6 bored. The Steelium Plus barrels are very, very nicely struck off. We've got a 14 and 7/8 inch standard length of pull with this pad, although the gun is supplied with a slightly longer pad, allowing you to take it out to 15 inches. I believe the gun is available in 30 and 32 inch. We've got ventilated mid and top rib with a white front bead. Coming back to the fore-end, this new fore-end design is really, really comfortable in the hand. The checkering is beautiful, the new fore-end latch is really, really nice. Just, it really feels like a quality bit of kit. If I whip the fore-end off, you can see that we've got mounting points for the Beretta BFOS weighting system, both in the fore-end or under the fore-end, and you can also buy the spring-loaded weights that attach to the barrel on the mid-rib. We've got this new adjustable system for tightening up the fore-end, and obviously I haven't footled with it, but I think that's going to be something useful over time. The ejectors on the gun have been revised. They no longer have the eco switches, so you can turn them off, because who does that? Coming back to the action, obviously we've got this new action design. It's probably the only part of the gun that I'm not happy with, if I'm honest. I have to mention it. I feel like this sort of square corner design kind of clashes a little bit with all the curves. It's a minor thing, and it's something that perhaps only I will notice, but I just feel like it jars a little bit. There's nothing in the rest of the gun that kind of mirrors that shape, but it is striking, and I think perhaps I'm probably going to be alone there. It looks very much sort of visually similar to the sort of lineup in terms of the DT11, etc. The new top lever shape is really, really comfortable. I've had no problems with it at all this week. Really, really nice. These scallops cut out here, where you actually have now the woodwork following the shape of the action, looks really well. It's a nice visual feature, actually. New safety design, really good. Not had any problems with it. Trigger's fine. It's an inertia unit, but the trigger pulls have been really consistent. No problems with it. Huge thing is this new palm swell. It's just great. It really is perfectly positioned, fills the hand nicely, and just gives you that great reference point in terms of your hand position on the gun. The stock, the comb is wider than on the 692, and I think it benefits hugely from that. Generally speaking, when the gun comes up, there's no tendency to roll over the comb. It just feels really, really nice. Very, very pleased with the shape of the gun and just the fit and feel. General sort of quality of finish, checkering. The woodwork on all the guns I've seen looks really, really good. If anything, this is probably the plainest one I've seen, because this is the press gun, but really, really enjoyed shooting it. I've given it a bit of exercise this week in terms of sporting, sport trap. I've shot some skeet, I've shot some DTL, and it's handled absolutely everything. Really, really nice to shoot. No nasty recoil impulses. It just comes up nicely. It balances lovely. This is the 32, and just absolutely cracking to shoot. Really, really enjoyed it. The gun is supplied with a BFast weighting system for the stock only. If you want the barrel weights, you do have to buy them aftermarket. I will get a price and a link to those and put it in the description below. But it does mean that you can basically set the gun up to balance how you want it. This gun, with it being a 32, is a touch nose heavy at the minute. I would be inclined to stick a couple of weights in the back end just to get it nice and neutral. But other than that, I haven't messed with it, and it's shot really, really nicely. Questions that I've been asked so far then. Is it better than a 692? Yes. It's, I think, a significant improvement on the 692 in every way. I think the changes that Beretta have made to the stock dimensions, this palm swell, the top lever, the fore-end shape, just the whole gun feels like it balances much, much better, and it just feels like a much more premium offering. I think it feels like a spiritual successor to the 682 Gold E. I always found the 692 to be a bit wandery and somewhat vague. This is just so deliberate and so easy to drive by comparison. I think this is a much better gun. Is it better than a 682 Gold E? Yes. I think that's a qualified yes, because It's difficult to find a decent 6.82 Goldie now, but if you're looking for something that's that good, but with a warranty, then I think this is absolutely the gun to go for. If you can still find a 6.82, absolutely, cracking gun. I just think this is a smidge better. I think there are some things about it that just, like, I prefer the shape of this forend, for instance, and the fact that it comes with a warranty. That just feels like a bit of a no-brainer. Is it better than a 7.25? Yes. This 7.25 has never been my favourite gun. I think the basic gun is a bit lump and a bit nasty. I just never a huge fan of it. This is way, way nicer to shoot. And finally, is it better than a 7.25 Pro Sport? I actually think it is. I think that Browning have dominated the mid-market for a long time. The Pro Sport is a cracking gun, but I think that with this at $3,000, including all the bits you get with it, with the weights and all the rest of it, and the fact that Browning checkering, and it's always been a thing that I go on about, is a bit rough, and this just looks a bit more quality. I think the wood on them's really nice. All the ones I've seen, other than this one, this being a press gun, the wood on them has been really, really nice quality. Checkering's fantastic. There are just no downsides, and I just think, do you know what? I think Beretta have done enough in the mid-market to actually dominate, and I think they're going to sell a lot of these. Oh. So to summarise, I think Beretta have really stolen a march here. I think they've done a great job of bringing something out in the sort of $3,000 mid-market that is going to dominate. I think Browning have got something to worry about, and I think you're going to see a lot of these on clay grounds moving forward in this in the coming year. Really, genuinely lovely gun to shoot. Yeah, I have no reservations. I don't think there's anything I don't like it other than, like I said, this square sort of motif on the action, which is really neither here nor there. Either you like it or you don't. Okay, guys, thank you very much for tuning in. Thank you very much to Imogen Wakatare of GMK for getting me the gun to test. Thank you for Bywell for obviously arranging the transfer. As ever, the channel is supported by Bywell Shooting Ground and Hull Cartridges, the confidence to win. If you enjoy the channel, please do subscribe, drop me a like, follow me on Instagram at Lloydie P, and I will see you in a couple of weeks. There may be some breaks coming up to upcoming episodes, because I'm off to Italy shortly, but I will be around and I'll try and do some stuff to sort of Instagram, etc., just to let you know where I am. Guys, I'll see you next time.